I love that burn right there.
In the building. It's Mixie fucking radio. I ain't motherfucking tired.
Mixie after dark.
And it's Mixie after dark.
That's that high class burn right there.
It's a dove.
Yo, some guys
that
shit.
Energy from last week. Hi, Tiffy.
Yo, what's going on?
That boo.
Puerto Rican princess.
The Puerto Rican princess is back in the building.
Take that building from Jocelyn.
Like that. Yo, not for nothing. The show is definitely like extra lit. We did the girl talk.
I see.
The pillow talk. It really goes down in the group chats and like this stuff. They on my Instagram. They're on my Facebook, Snapchat, all that good stuff. So make sure you follow them. They definitely lit. They're gonna be up here again. I think I'm going to call them It's a Vibe because when they pull up, it was like a vibe.
It's definitely a vibe.
All talking. But we have our two guests in the building. This is kind of cool because we never interviewed two separate guests at the exact same time. Yeah, that's exactly what we're going to do. So I'm going to let you guys introduce yourself and where you're from. A little bit something about yourself before we get into the topics.
What's good, y'all? The Chicken Man, FCC, C-Class, Brownsville, Brooklyn, on this creative Let's Go No Bitches story.
And it's a copy.
It's the Holy One King P. Brooklyn, New York. I'm tequila fucked up right now.
Somebody brought tequila, and I was like, so this is what happened. Can I have a conversation? It was like, rum or tequila. I was like, Henny, the fuck? Then I was told, that's not an option. I was like, well, if you're going to make tequila, make sure you bring gold, because it needs to be dark tequila. Because Free, I'm going to just say, that's a fact. And Free is free off of work. I've been off of work technically for 2 hours, so I'm going to be free and not free from, whatever I work. I've been drinking for a while.
That's all right. We're going to let you drink and enjoy
and
your life.
And it's like a mixture of shit.
It's
all right. So, I was like, I got to be dark. for me to get through the rest of my life. And you got it. The dings are on point tonight. No ding. I have to ask nobody for no ding.
I'm
sorry. It's lit. First of all, that's bullshit. I've had to ask everybody. I had to cue my shit at 8, but I feel like niggas was like on the same energy from last week.
Shout out to Dizzy.
Ding-a-ling-a-ling. We're not shouting out Dizzy for a dad. Wow. But the princess is back.
I'm Jamaican.
So I'm hype. Hi, princess. I don't keep fake. Halfway not recognized you last week. But then, like, it's like you're a bad. So I'm like, all right, cool.
Yeah, you feel me? I had to come back, like, opposite the front. But
you look crazy.
I just came back.
Oh, you just got high five? Yes, princess. So we got two guests in the building. You guys already introduced yourselves, so tell us what you do and what you
want. I'm a hip hop artist, out of Brooklyn, like I said. I got my album on everywhere. It's Holy University.
Last time you
came,
you told us you were working on it.
Yeah, so I finally got it out the way. Tracks 1 through 16, everything is fucking dope. So that's available on Apple Music, Spotify, Tidal, Your Grandmother's 8-track, a record.
Your Grandmother's what?
8-track.
Her 8-track. Okay, it's anybody got a grandmother with an 8-track? It's there. There we go.
It's everywhere right now, so just make sure you go cop it, give it a listen. And shit, I'm here. But this tequila is
He came in and he did good. Mr. Chicken Man, sir.
Yeah, he definitely got it. Chicken Man, baby.
You know what I'm saying? Chicken Man, baby.
We got to dance before I go.
I like to learn.
Yeah, the chicken dance.
Yeah, you got to ask him about that chicken, man. Like, you know what's crazy about them? Since somebody hit me up, like, yo, I see you got, yo, his promo game is real. Like, oh, frick. Like, promo game is real. And then, like, niggas from Brownsville hit me up, too. Like, yo, can I pull up? I'm like, yo, bro, talk to him. Like, why y'all asking me? Can y'all pull up? Talk to him. But y'all booming right now, man. Like, definitely. But let everybody know a little bit about what you do.
I mean, pretty much, I'm the creator, director, writer, editor of Let's Go New Vintage Story.
Yeah.
It's an original series on YouTube. We got about 4.7 million views right now.
Wow.
We also have a Christmas movie out that's a comedy as well. We have a soundtrack out called Let's Go Volume 1. That's out already also. We're working on another track called Let's Go Africa with a DJ out Africa. And also we got Let's Go South, my man. He the president of Let's Go South. That's our marketing, promotion, and distribution down there with our DVDs, mixtapes, and all that stuff. And about 5 states we got down there so far. And we've been doing a campaign for GoFundMe. Actually, last night we had a telethon. We did a telethon last night. We brought it back. We was on YouTube Live. Had the phones call up, make a pledge. We was performing, dancing, having fun about 4 hours. So, you know, it was very interactive last night. You know what I mean? That's why I'm tired now. I've got a voice.
It's all right. As long as you're grinding. I mean, at the end of the day, that's what it's about. You feel me? Like, it's a grind. So, let's go back to you, brother, man. You've been busy. I know you've been busy.
Yeah, man. I'm just, like, I dropped the album on March 24th. So it's like 2 weeks old. So, like, since then, I've been doing, like, radio interviews. I've been doing shows. I just came off of 2 shows. Shout out More Bookings for Day Summit. I just did that concert. Well, I didn't even realize that it was actually a competition until I got there. So when I got there, it was like it was a competition and everything, and ended up winning the competition, finishing in the top 3. So I move on to the next round, like win a chance to go to Paris and all of that, and perform it, like at a concert over there. So yeah, you know, Jean-Claude Van Damme and all that. I'm just trying to keep the momentum going and just trying to keep working and everything like that. So you already know, once I dropped the album, I had to come up here.
Of course.
I had to come up here and drop it and, you know, teach you guys about it and stuff like that. So I'm really, really proud of the project. Like I said, Holy University available everywhere.
Your grandmother's 8-track is what the man said it was on.
We got a hashtag. Okay. Grandma 8-track.
Grandma 8-track. Hashtag Grandma 8-track. It's lit.
And then we met before besides the show. You performed.
Signature Series. Yeah. No, Oxygen Fest.
You definitely. He was a DJ for one of the DJs. I don't know. Probably Dre DJ.
I was chilling. Dre was DJ.
Yeah, I think it was.
Dre was DJ. I was
providing sound. Yeah. So you definitely say that. How was that performance of that?
I mean, it was different. For the most part, like, when I go to a lot of shows and stuff like that, I normally go to Dolly, probably, like, 2-3 people with me. So, I'm literally going to, like, wow the whole crowd over. Because I know at that point in time, you're here with your peoples and everybody that, you know, came to support you.
Yeah.
So, It was love when I came off the stage, and everybody was just like, yo, like, your set was dope. You know what I mean? People was just like, you're lyrical as fuck and all that good shit. So, I mean, I was like, yo, good looks and everything. So, it's always good to, like, get that feel, that vibe. That venue was dope, too.
Yeah.
That venue was really, really dope.
Yeah, we had a good time.
You know what I'm saying? So, I'm just, like I said, like, I just got to keep moving with that momentum. and just keep pushing from there. You know what I'm saying?
All right, cool. Man, chicken's in the zone right now, man. Yeah. So you are artist also. Alright, so what's up with you and your shows? Like any shows coming up, any shows you previously did?
Well, we did a couple shows. We did a couple shows in Virginia. We did one in Georgia. We did a couple of showcases up here in New York. The Chicken Man single is about to be out, so that's coming out. And then we're gonna do single release parties in each of the cities that we got chapters in. And then the next series is coming out in July.